Welcome to Control Engineering Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you closed loop control system in this video. And this video is made in comparison with my previous video that was based on open loop control system. So here we will study closed loop control system in comparison with open loop control system. So let us try to understand closed loop control system with its block diagram first. Where as if you observe control system, then in that control system basic block diagram, here we give input and here we take output. But to see its detailed block diagram, here we'll be having input and that is what we will be giving it to controller. Controller will generate controlled signal and here we'll be having output. But as this name suggests, closed loop control system, here our agenda is to take output in feedback. Right, so here we will be taking output in feedback. So this feedback will generate feedback signal over here. And before we give signal to input to the controller, here we take error detector and that will be generating error signal. So here this error signal will be given to controller and this error signal is having idea about input as well as output. Why? The reason is this error signal, that will be difference in between input signal and feedback signal as if this is error detector with negative feedback. So with respect to error, controller will generate controlled signal and plant will get operated. So here one thing that one should understand, because of this feedback, now controller is having idea about input as well as output. So if any disturbance is getting generated at output side, that disturbance can be nullified by this feedback signal as per error signal. So this is what one basic advantage which is there with closed loop control system, in that controller is having idea about input as well as output due to feedback. So in closed loop system, output is used by controller via feedback, right? So here this output, that is what we are using via feedback. That is what the major agenda which is there with closed loop system. And here we have feedback. So due to feedback, it will compensate the disturbance which is happening at output side. So as we compensate disturbance at output side, you will be finding accuracy of the closed loop system, that is way greater than open loop system, right? So this is what the basic block diagram which is there with closed loop system, where there are two additional things. One is feedback and second is error detector. So here in controller input, we have error signal. That is a difference in between input and feedback signal. And here we have a feedback, right? So these are the differences which is there in open loop and closed loop system. Now let us see the applications. So that will resolve your understanding furthermore. So one major application, that is air conditioner, AC. Now you see in air conditioner, we use closed loop system. Let us try to understand how we use closed loop system. For example, in this AC by remote control, if we set temperature to 26 degrees Celsius, then once we set this temperature to 26 degrees Celsius, this AC will get turned on. Now once it will be cooling this room to 26 degrees Celsius temperature, after having that temperature, it will turn off the AC. So it will not continuously, it will stay on. It will be maintaining that temperature, right? So here what we do, here we measure a temperature of this room and we give it in feedback. And with respect to difference in actual temperature and the temperature to be maintained, this AC will get turned on and turned off. Right, for example, right now if room temperature is 28 and if we set that temperature to 26, then this AC will get turned on. And once this temperature of room is set to 26 degrees Celsius, then this AC will get turned off. After some time period, it may be possible that temperature may increase with respect to time. And again, if it is increasing to 26.5, then for some time period, again, it will get turned on and it will maintain it to 26 degrees Celsius. So this is closed loop system. And because of this feedback, it will be power efficient air conditioner over here, which will not use energy for continuous time period, it will be using energy as per the requirement. So that's why this closed loop system is efficient. Now, next application is water level controller. So here in water level controller, we are having two modes, manual and auto. Here we have a tank and here we have a reservoir. So in water level controller, once you set this to auto mode, in that case, this motor will get turned on with respect to water level. So if water level goes below the maintained level, in that case, this motor will get turned on and this reservoir will fill this water in this tank. So in auto mode, this water level controller will fill this tank automatically with respect to time, where we don't need manual control. As if it is there in manual control, then we need to fill this water with respect to some time. But as if it is there in auto control, by feedback, feedback is what? Output of this tank. If that output of this tank is going below some level, then this motor will get turned on and it will fill this water inside of this tank. So that is how closed loop system applications are there. Now, I'll explain you advantages and disadvantages of closed loop system. So see, closed loop system are more accurate even in the presence of non-linearity. So if any disturbance is happening at output side, because of feedback, controller will recorrect that output because of feedback, which is there in closed loop system. So this is what more accurate compared to open loop system. It is highly accurate as error is getting corrected by presence of feedback signal. You'll be finding large bandwidth is there with closed loop system compared to open loop system. And by open loop system, we cannot facilitate that to automation, but by having closed loop system, we provide facility of automation. Why? The reason is now, because of feedback, we have some automatic control which is happening in the system. So we provide some facilities to automation. The sensitivity of system may be made small to make system stable. You'll be finding with closed loop control system, there are issues regarding stability, but those issues regarding stability can be resolved by lowering sensitivity of the system. So here, if you make sensitivity of system small, then we can have higher stability with the system in closed loop system. So this is what one advantage you'll be finding. Sensitivity of closed loop system is usually lower compared to open loop system, right? But you can make sensitivity further low to have higher stability. Closed loop systems are less affected by noise, as we have discussed it. We have feedback, and based on feedback, we can have recorrection of that signal which is there with controller, and based on that, we can obtain higher accuracy. So you'll be finding closed loop systems are less affected by noise. Now let us discuss disadvantages of closed loop system. So you'll be finding we have more number of blocks. We need measurement at output side. We need feedback. We need error detector compared to open loop system. So you'll be finding closed loop systems are costlier and complex. Due to feedback, system may get unstable. So this is one major disadvantage which is there with closed loop system. Due to feedback, you'll be finding overall gain of the system will reduce. So in future videos, I'll explain you what will be overall gain due to feedback. So we will derive feedback gain due to open loop and closed loop system, and we will see how overall gain is reducing due to feedback. So you'll be finding feedback reduces overall gain of system. Closed loop system requires more maintenance compared to open loop system. And you'll be finding due to feedback, there will be some oscillation which will happen in the response of the system. So feedback leads oscillatory response in closed loop system. So these are the disadvantages which is there with closed loop system. I hope that you have understood this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions so that in future videos I can recorrect all those issues and I can optimize those things which is required over here. Thank you so much for watching this video.